Hi guys, this is Boris here, bringing you some new videos about Pokemon Go and especially about PvP and maybe some videos also about raids. So in the first half of this video I'm gonna show you the Pokemons that I have, the legendary and the mythical, and the Pokemons that I have to use on the all three leagues, Masters, Ultra and Great League. So here you can see that I don't have a lot of legendary. Most of them that I have comes from that weekly box, and some of them are from the PvP rewards. Here in the mythical I have some got doing some raids, some of them are from the Melton box. Here you can see the place where I grind. You have two Pokestops right up there and a gym right over there. They're about 500 meters from my place, and this is the place where I grind, so I don't have a lot of dust to invest in all of those Pokemon. And as you saw back there, I don't have those meta Pokemon or PvP perfect Pokemon. So yeah, I'm gonna show you that it's possible to reach higher ranks with little dust and good investment. Here you see I am level 39, I reached level 40 early this week. So as I told you in the beginning, I am going to show you now the Pokemon that I have. Those were the for the Masters League. I don't have a lot. Here are from the Ultra League. I also don't have a lot of choice. And these here are for the Great League, that I have a little more to pick, but they are not PvP perfect. One or two maybe are great, but not that PvP that you want. So here is a bonus for you guys from the Throwback Challenge Kanto. I didn't have any Mewtwo, as you saw, and this is my first Mewtwo, and boom, a shiny Mewtwo. Yeah, I was pretty excited about it. The Mewtwo is one of my top Pokemon that I like, and yeah, as you saw, that ball was a little crazy. So yeah, I was pretty happy about it, and yeah, it was really great. Thank you, Niantic. Now let's check out the IV, and it's a 96, so pretty good Pokemon. Now the part that we all be waiting for, the battles. So here, as you can see, I'm running this team with Wigglytuff in the lead, a Sableye as a safe switch, and a Azumarill in the back. So Sableye is really good. It's a rank 1, it's a hundo. It's a really expensive Pokemon, but it's really, really great. I powered it up little by little, so yeah, it was pretty good. I didn't have an Azumarill, I built one recently, and I'm pretty satisfied about it. I was waiting for the perfect Azumarill since this is a little expensive Pokemon. So he's in the first battle really bad lead, but I make a horrible mistake. I swap. Yeah, this was my mistake right here. I should stay, I should sack the Wigglytuff, farm it down the best that I could, and then brought out the Azumarill to finish it off and leave the Sableye. That was my win condition. And yeah, mistakes were made, and I'm learning as I go. It's really good because you learn a lot from your mistakes. Normally you forget your wins, but you never forget your losses. So yeah, this was a good learning match, as you say. This Mach has a lot of energy, but he will swap out. I thought he made it to the Sludge Wave, maybe barely, but not. This Gloom will shredder my Azumarill. I think I can get to 2 Ice Beams, but it doesn't matter because he has a full Pokemon in the back And mais uma would be with no health. I think, yeah, I make to a nice game. But that is already a good game. So good first game for learning. When you catch grass in the front, you should sack the Wigglytuff, doing that charm damage. The Wigglytuff in this video has Dazzling Gleam, but I change it to play rough. I didn't notice that it was bringing Dazzling Gleam until the end of this set. I didn't need to use it, but yeah, it's play rough, it's a little more energy efficient. So really good lead in this match. Yeah, I took too long to swap. Didn't know what was I thinking, and this was my mistake number two. I thought this was only a discharge or a thunderbolt, but it was a flash cannon. So yeah, my Sableye didn't do nothing to this Magneton. I brought out Wigglytuff. Now let's see what my opponent is gonna bring. A Scissor. So I'm thinking right here that Charm will chunk down this Scissor because of his dark bug typing, sorry. So I'm giving my Wigglytuff two shields. I am shielding whatever it comes from here, because if he brought a Scissor to this Wigglytuff, what he has in the back must be really weak to Wigglytuff. So I'm giving it up two shields. I tried to sack the Azu to bring out the Azumarill to the charge move. And I'm trying to we'll try to farm down this Caesar a little bit. Yeah, but you change it up, and yeah, I brought out Gallade, but this Ice Beam will bring down Gallade. No shields, so hell yeah, a shield. Yeah. But it's okay for me. I thought he had no shields. I'm pretty okay with that. Psychic would do a lot, but I think I can get to an Ice Beam. Or maybe not. No, I don't get an Ice Beam, but Wigglytuff has an Ice Beam ready. I overtapped right there, was a mistake, because this Gallade had already a charge move ready. It would be game over for me. So a lot of I made a little mistakes, my opponent also made them, but yeah, I was pretty happy with this team. Let's see the third match. So this set, I'm running to some really bad leads. At this lower rank, I'm currently rank 7, but at this lower ranks I run into some spicy leads. And yeah, as you see here, a really bad one. I brought out the Azumarill, and I'm thinking if he's not swapping, he must have Thunderbolt. So yeah, Thunderbolt, I correctly shield that. I'm going for the shield bait. I could have gone for Hydro Pump, and I'm hoping that shields come out, but no shields. I'm still in a shield disadvantage. I don't know if I shield. I don't shield. Okay. Thunderbolt goes through. It does a lot. I'm going now for the Ice Beam bait again, trying to get those shields to come out and save a little energy. But my opponent, yeah, I'm really bad at baiting, because in all of these matches I bait, and yeah, it's really bad for me. Don't know if I shield. I don't shield. Okay. This rock slide is enough to take me out. I come out with Wigglytuff to farm a little. It will be very bad if I go into a 2 shields disadvantage. Hypno, so this is okay. I think I'm gonna get to a nice beam first. No, we will get to this is likely a thunder punch and a nice punch or a fire punch. Yeah, fire punch. And now I bring out Sableye. He's doing a lot. He has Alolan Marowak in the back, so this is really good for me because now it all depends on my Sableye. I can get to two foul plays, I guess. No, barely. So I don't know if I shield right here. I shield and he baits me with Bone Club. I don't know if I needed to shield if it was a Shadow Ball. Yeah, I needed to shield if it was a Shadow Ball. But yeah, he baits me and I took the bait. Oh, my win condition is right here when he didn't. When my opponent didn't double shield on Alolan Marowak, because now I only need to farm this Hypno down with Sableye and or with Wigglytuff. This is already game over for my opponent. I think he recognized that and let his charge move go. Yeah, so able to come back from that lead with a really bad lead. With those baits to don't work out. So name game number 4 against Team Rocket Mark. Let's see if I got a good lead. No, another bad lead for me. I don't know what I bring. Bring out Azumarill, okay. Rock Slide or Super Power won't do enough. Yeah, a little chip damage. And he swaps into Raichu. So I'm forcing here the shields and I will let this Azumarill go and bring out Sableye and give him both shields because Sableye can handle these two. Sableye is a really good Pokemon. I use it sometimes, not my favorite one, but I have to use it because it's a rank 1 in PvP, so yeah. It's really great. It isn't the best buddy Sableye, I'm working on it to give him that extra combat power. I'm able to farm down this Alolan Raichu. And he brings out Melmetal. So this foul plays will surely add up. He shields. I have a shield. I don't know if I shield right here. I think I let this one go through. Yeah. Let this rock slide. It does a lot to. So he has Deoxys in the back. I don't know if I win this one. This is going to be a close match. I build it to a foul play, more or less, and bring out Wigglytuff. Now I don't. I only think I need one Shadow Claw, maybe two. Yeah, let's see. I changed it a little late, maybe it was a little bit sooner. I have a nice beam ready, so let's see if I can get this win. This Melmetal has a lot of energy. Okay, but yeah, it's game over. One Shadow Claw would do the trick. I have a shield, so even if he throws the charge move, it's already game over. Yeah. So good games. I only brought to you 4 battles because the fifth there was my opponent crashed, so yeah, not worth showing you guys. So if you like these videos, please follow me on Twitter, Twitch, and the Patreon is on the description below. So make sure to like, comment and subscribe. Thank you guys and see you in the next video.